Hello, Central New York. Good Friday morning to you. I'm Storm Team Meteorologist John DePasquale hanging out with you. We take a look here at our severe weather risk. It goes through about 12 or 1 o'clock this afternoon. All right. Biggest threat with any of the storms that develop. Strong damaging winds, 50 to 60 miles per hour, maybe a little bit of hail, and a very low chance of an isolated tornado. Not too concerned about that chance, but can't totally rule it out. So we'll keep an eye on them, those storms. And then flooding, no real risk of flooding because these storms are fast movers, though it will produce some heavy rains at times, these thunderstorms. Look here at your live Doppler 9. You can see Syracuse southwestbound, pretty quiet, just a few sprinkles here and there. That is it. Heavier band of rain and thunderstorms working their way quickly to the northeast at 60 to 70 miles an hour. You can see Boonville getting wet right now down to just north of Rome. A little thunder and lightning for you in Trenton. Utica getting wet on the thruway there. And we got some pretty good rain and some lightning, pretty good lightning there over the Tug Hill up to near Watertown. Again, not much going on across the Finger Lakes. However, can't let our guard down because we got a cold front pushing into western New York right now. And ahead of this front, got a line of shower and storms that isn't looking quite as impressive as it looked just an hour ago, but still it is pretty pumped up with some very heavy rains and gusty winds of 40 to 50 miles per hour right along the front edge of this band here, right there, slicing through Rochester and just southeast of Buffalo. This is marching its way to the northeast as well. So watching this band of showers developing, we'll see how this comes together again right ahead of the cold front over the next few hours. That is the line we're going to have to watch as that cold front races through. So right now it's mild, 60s, well to the 60 temperature wise with even a few breaks of sunshine. To the west though, we drop into the 40s out toward Toronto and Detroit, and that's the air that's going to blow in here later this afternoon and this evening. Take a look at these temperatures. So we're feeling good right now. It's going to be feeling a little chillier, more normal for this time of year by the end of the day, as temperatures will be back into the 40s with wind chills in the 30s with winds gusting at times potentially upwards of 50 to 55 miles an hour. So here's the setup. Low pressure now should be drawn here, right near Toronto. Cold front in western New York that will race through central New York as we go through the midday hours. So let's look at your time cast. 10 a.m. Scattering of showers and a few thunder showers trying to race their way through here. Again, the risk for severe weather is low, but it's there. Temperatures nosedive from the 60s into the 50s during the afternoon. I think by the end of the day, we're in the 40s with a few lingering showers. So it does turn drier as we go into the late day hours and early tonight. But still, again, a few showers linger, especially up toward the Tug Hill and the Adirondacks, where there could even be a few snow showers going into tonight. Temperatures back off into the 30s, some partial clearing later tonight. And tomorrow, a blend of cloud and sun and not a bad day. Winds are light out of the west southwest, 5 to 10 miles an hour. High temperatures, upper 40s to mid 50s. Not too shabby. Tomorrow night, it's quiet, but clouds increase and it turns a little breezy late tomorrow night. Could be a late night shower. Temperatures are within a few degrees of 40 for a low tomorrow night and rising late. And then as we go to Sunday, we got some rain developing later morning into the afternoon. Could be heavy at times ahead with this cold front in the wake of it. A little bit of a lull late Sunday, and then Sunday night, the secondary cold front will produce some rain and snow showers that will end as snow showers Sunday night, very early Monday, and may deposit according to an inch of snow, especially in the hills. As we go through Monday, we've got some sun. It's brisk, it's chillier, 40 to 45, but not horrible for this time of year. On Tuesday, we're talking back into the 60s with some sunshine. Wednesday could be a couple late day showers and still mild. And then ironically, as we kick off the month of April next Thursday, it's going to feel a little bit like winter with maybe even a few snow showers, temperatures 30s to around 40.